We'll be hearing from Amna first and then Samir, but first, my little friend here wants to say, give you a message.
Yeah!
Solidarity for everyone, she said.
Hello everyone, I'm Amna from Afghans For Peace, and I'll be doing a poem about war and all the oppression that we go through. Recently, as the war in Afghanistan is going to be extended again, and we are so tired from paying for illegal wars. How long is this oppression going to go on? From our taxes, it's blood money that's burning, that's creating more blood. So I don't understand why so many people are still in support of this war, yet there's 58% who disagree for the extension of this war. So I don't know why this war is still going to be extended. However, I'm going to be reading a poem called Breaking Free from Suppression. And this is for Afghanistan and all the oppressed nations, from Palestine to Pakistan to Haiti. Woo! Borders are barriers for love to expand. They are the ways for wars to extend, fighting for gaining more and more land so we can wave our flags from each corner. Because the size of our land defines our strength. We promote peace and say war was not our intent. Deception is how we gather our supporters while we play battle with our friends on the next border, just to deceive the masses so they can continue paying for illegitimate wars. After all, that is how we put gas in our cars, spilling blood for the sake of drilling oil. Their greedy wild agenda makes my blood boil. I see corporations controlling as if they're business dealers. I see them selling medications promising our wounds would heal. But I'm wounded deeply in my heart, and the scar is from your knife. The damage was done when I was trying to revolt from your strife. You promised me a washed-up word, democracy. I only receive pseudo-equality. Your system is filled with hypocrisy. How is it fair when you drive a Rolls Royce, when I drown in inflation from high price? How is it fair when your mansion size is equivalent to a home for 30 people, and the money you spend on it daily will be able to make us all equal? The price you pay for your wine can help me eat for days. And I'm supposed to hold on tight because this is a bad phase? My food I can't afford, my rent I cannot pay. And you expect me to believe what you say? This damage can't be fixed with an overpriced construction. I'm speaking of broken homes, broken hearts, and broken bones. I'm speaking of the oppressed, widows, victims, and animal clones. I'm speaking of peace, I'm speaking for equality. I'm asking for all of us to have more morality. I know my thoughts will not be televised since they're revolutionary. And the truth should be kept hidden since it will take over delusionaries. So continue spreading lies, and the truth will prevail. You can't always keep the truth under a veil. Your mask will come off. It's already starting to. You can dump the masses down however you want to. But when they wake up from this deep sleep, then you should be ready to see how a shepherd follows its sheep. Thank you so much.
Afghans for Peace. Woo! We're a movement against the illegal occupation of Afghanistan. It's incredible to see the amount of people that have gathered here today. We must realize that the struggle of us working class Canadians, all who have gathered here today, is not different than the struggle of those under occupation. While we see unemployment skyrocket, homelessness, the cost of living grasping out of our reach, and the social services and workers' rights that a peaceful, prosperous society needs, we need to realize that this local struggle is linked with the greater struggle of the oppressed people. The very capitalist mongers who have caused us to suffer here are active in the oppressing of the Afghans, the Libyans, the Iraqis, the Haitians, the Palestinians, to name but a few. It is the same conflict we're facing. And what's worse, all the carnage from Palestine to Afghanistan to Iraq to wherever is next. These atrocities have been carried out in our name as somehow providing us with a sense of freedom, as somehow liberating the people of these countries. For 11 long years, the Afghan people have been living under the brutal occupation by the United States, by Canada, and by NATO. Is the destruction of homes, the slaughter of innocents, the countless night raids and bombings, the rape of thousands of women somehow enhanced our sense of freedom? Has it somehow liberated the women of Afghanistan?
No!
Somehow made Afghanistan a safe place?
No!
Fed the children of the country? there is one thing clear about the conflict in Afghanistan, it is that the war has not helped the lives of the regular Afghan. Now, Prime Minister Harper has suggested that Canadian troops will be staying in Afghanistan past 2014.
Shame!
Shame!
Yet again, this government has lied to the Canadian people. Why? Because it is the working class families who bear the burden, here and in Afghanistan. Here in Canada, it is their loved ones being sent off to fight and to die. It is their money, it is our money that is stolen to pay for war and for occupation. Only the elite and those on Wall Street and Main Street have reaped the benefits of this conflict. I stand before you as an Afghan, a member of Afghans for Peace, calling on you to be those anti-war voices. We need to unite, we need to stand up, because this is our time to call for peace and justice and to call for an end to all wars of aggression and imperialism. Thank you.